Katherine Johnson and Chad Shelton died. He treated Stephen Harper's dog and cat. They both had unexplained bleeding, and both animals died.
That is exactly what happened to Gloria Johnson, and that real convinced me that this is rebel.
But police had a problem. They had plenty of circumstantial evidence linking Harper to the poisonings, but they had no scientific proof. DMN is rapidly metabolized in the body and excreted within hours of ingestion, so there was no trace of it in any of the victims. There was, in effect, no murder weapon.
We had a whole bunch of theories and suppositions and no evidence before we were out.
We had to, in some other way, prove that DMN had been there.
At the University of California at Irvine, Dr. Ronald Shank, a cancer researcher, had been conducting animal experiments looking at how cancer-causing agents like DMN altered the DNA.
Dimethylglycosylate attacks the DNA of the liver cell, and it leaves a chemical footprint on the DNA. That footprint will lead to a mutation which starts the cancer process.
Dr. Kimbrough asked Ronald Shank if he would try something he had never done before, to conduct his first human experiment. He sent 8 coated samples of liver and kidney tissue in order to conduct a blind test. One of the samples belonged to Dwayne Johnson, although Dr. Shank had no idea which one. High-performance liquid chromatography separated the various components of the DNA, and the computer charted those components visualized on a graph.
DNA from 7 of the 8.
Y'all know I'm a Colts fan.
One liver sample had DNA that gave us 2 extra peaks in the liquid chromatography. Those 2 extra peaks were identical to what you would see if the individual had been exposed to dimethylglycosylate.
The liver sample belongs to Dwayne Johnson.
That's what Shank and Kendra did for. He proved it beyond a reasonable doubt that this is a substitute to exclude from any other known substitute.
Science provided the murder weapon. Other evidence would provide the full picture of Stephen Harper's deranged mind.
On corrupt crimes, he's the man at the top of the Juarez cartel.
He establishes the criminal enterprise.
He'll do whatever it takes to stay there.
Brutality is what kept him in power.
Then, America's most promising neighbor is also the dirtiest.
At every single level.
Corrupt crime. Tonight, 9, 8 central. On the New York State, slip away. And from mystery, that
is unbelievable.
Unsolved mystery. Midnight 7-6 central. On the New York State, slip away.
That's what I see.
Leather, not shoe leather, like a belt, a barrel
weight. You can get piggy with your beer. Why don't you piggy with your TV?
Introducing a la carte TV, only from Sling. Start at $20 a month, then get your personal channel in and save.
I drew this one in my bathtub.
That's so gross.
Go to slingtv.com and start watching 7 days free.
There's nothing worse than not having a warm coat when it's freezing outside.
That's why we're at Burlington.
They have coats for play, work, the weekend, at prices you would not believe. Wow.
Hey, cold weather, we're ready with you.
Jealousy and rage over Sandy Johnson's rejection. With Harper in prison for the shooting, his bizarre behavior continued. He mailed these pictures depicting Sandy as a witch to her home. Initially, Sandy Johnson couldn't believe that her old boyfriend was capable of murder, which explains why she didn't identify him as a possible suspect. Their unusual relationship was the focus of Thomas Meehan's book, Toxic Love.
She has painted the former boyfriend, Stephen Harper, as a very peaceful person, as a very loving person, as a very good person. He was not prone to violence, quote unquote. That sort of portrayal. Very puzzling, very perplexing. Why would she do that? I don't know.
After prison, Harper took a job at the F. Lee Cancer Institute. Published reports say it was here where Harper first learned about the death of DMX. A newspaper article had been posted on the company's bulletin board, describing how a German man killed his wife by putting DMX in her marmalade. Authorities believe that Harper confiscated DMX from a locked refrigerator in the lab and experimented at home to find the correct dosage. Harper